Hello viewers, my name is Vikas Deep. I am from Kushal Educare Services. In case you do not know the meaning of Kushal, then Kushal means expert. So in our science playlist, the basic idea is how to make students understand the concepts. You see, excellent description is given in the textbook and is also having diagrams. So the textbooks are written by some of the best of the brains available in our country. Sometimes it so happens that seeing is believing. So when you see the specimen, when you observe the nature, when you see it in reality, then it is more clear. We are showing you the specimen. We are not showing this, showing animations. Animations are strict no. We are also not showing diagrams because they are already given in the textbook. We are showing you the specimen, the plants and animals, so you can observe and then understand. For example, in the past, we have uploaded videos which describe so many technical terms. In case you have not yet gone through our botany playlist, it is there. You can see the thumbnail. The URL is given in the description box, and also the zoology playlist, the thumbnail is there. You can identify, and zoology URL playlist URL is also there in the description box. Coming to the today's video, today we are going to discuss about a very important hydrophytic plant which grows in water. This plant produces beautiful magenta purple color flowers. This is not a plant of Indian origin. In fact, its origin, if you trace, it comes from South America. And this plant specimens I have collected here from a lake in Lucknow city. Yesterday I went there. There's a place called as Kathota Lake. So first let me show you the place from where I have collected this specimen. Then we are going to discuss about this plant. So here you are seeing this beautiful lake, and the way we love to fell the trees and destroy the beautiful landscape and convert everything into a concrete jungle. I am not sure in another, let's say 5-10 years, we will be having this lake or not, but for now we can enjoy this beautiful lake, the beautiful nature. Maybe next generation may not be so fortunate. And in case you are living in a house in one of such tall buildings, then visiting such a place and enjoying fresh air and nature is in itself a big relief. So here on the outer side, on the outskirts of the lake, this is our target hydrophyte plant that we are going to study. Can you identify it? Can you identify this plant? So these plants are in the vegetative stage. They have not yet produced flowers, but in the flowering stage they produce beautiful magenta and purple color flowers. Now these plants, they are undergoing vegetative propagation, and with the help of vegetative propagation they are able to spread on the surface of the water. If you go near the near this lake and try to lift them, you can very easily lift them. As you can see that they are floating on the surface, so they are surface hydrophytes. You can easily lift them. They are not attached to the soil with the help of their roots. They are floating hydrophytic plants. So this is a floating hydrophyte plant. The roots, leaves and the plant in general shows various adaptations. Okay, so first important point to note is that the leaves, you can see that leaves are present in a dense cluster. Leaves are present close together, so you can see that the internodes have been highly reduced and it is present in the dense cluster. Similarly for the roots also, if you see, let me show you the roots. The roots are fibrous type. They are fibrous type of roots. Okay, so roots are fibrous and roots are also clustered together. So you can see here, these roots are also called as balancing organs. And you can see here the adaptation of the petiole. The petiole is here, you can see it is bulbous type. You can see here that this helps in floating. If I cut it and show you from the inside, It is like this. So you can see that it is having a lot of air spaces. If I am pressing it, then I can hear the sound of air gushing out. If I completely immerse this cut petiole in water and press it, you can see air bubbles. What is the source of the air? The air is trapped inside this petiole. See, again, I will press it. You can see air bubbles coming out. That is why the tissue inside is also called as Aerenchyma. Aerenchyma means a tissue which can hold air. Aerenchyma we will also study inside microscope. See here, this is a cut petiole. I am dipping it in the water. When I press it, you can see the air bubbles. So it is a adaptation which helps a plant to float. Then another important feature is, in this specimen you can see this is a horizontal branch. This is a branch, but it is running in a horizontal direction, not in the vertical direction. So this is called as an offset. This branch is an horizontal growing branch, is an offset. It is a method of vegetative reproduction, that is reproduction with the help of the vegetative body. It is because of this only that this plant spreads on the surface of water very fast. So observe the roots here. Can you see at the tip of it a black color portion? That is basically the root pockets. So as you know that the hydrophytic plants, their roots do not have a root cap. So these are vestigial organs. These are root pockets. So here observe, roots are fibrous, present in a dense cluster, and their ends, can you see that black color portion? Those are the root pockets. Okay, now let us cut a section of this petiole, the stem, and see inside the histological modifications or histological adaptation. So now, dear viewer, we are going to observe the slide having section of petiole under the microscope. So as you see the slide, you should observe the outermost layer of epidermis. The epidermis layer, as I have told you before also in one of the previous videos on deep stomata, that epidermis layer is devoid of chlorophyll. And after that, you are having a general cortex layer. The general cortex is having chlorophyll. You will be able to observe it, the green color. This is followed by the special tissue Aerenchyma. The large air spaces will be visible as white color areas. You should be able to observe large white colored areas in the cortex. Those are basically the air spaces, and those white color areas are the air gaps, so where air is filled in. So what happens is that this Aerenchyma, you should realize, it serves a dual purpose. Of course, it increases the buoyancy of the petiole and the plant as a whole. But other than that, it is also providing an internal atmosphere. So Aerenchyma is serving dual purpose. One is it is increasing buoyancy, and second is it is also providing a sort of internal atmosphere where gaseous exchanges can take place. Next is, you should be able to observe pointed structures. These pointed structures are of two types. One is the sclereids. And the type of sclereids that you should be able to observe are the astrosclereids. Astrosclereids are very common in the stems of hydrophytes. The astrosclereids are a type of branch sclereids. And another important type of structure you should be able to observe are the pointed calcium oxalate crystals. So next important structure is the vascular structure, that is the transport element. As you know, Eichhornia is a monocot. and that is why you are seeing a large number of scattered vascular bundles. The pink color structures, which are interspersed in between the white color air gaps, are the vascular structures. The reddish pink structures you are seeing are the transport elements. Here I have magnified the view. You can see the vascular bundles are close type, that is cambium is absent. This means this plant will not show secondary growth. The large color structures, large colored vessels, are the xylem. In a highly magnified view, you can see Sclerenchyma just near to the air gaps. The narrow diameter structures are the phloem. So dear viewer, this was Eichhornia. We have seen the morphological adaptations as well as some anatomical details. Next time we will come soon with another interesting video on some other plant or animal. Please do tell us how you like this video in the comment section. Thank you.